Okay, everyone, welcome in this new tutorial. This time we will learn how to come from cycle to Luxcore. This tutorial is for people coming from cycle with a good background and want to create stunning frames, like you can see on the start of the video. Stunning things with Luxcore. And when you start to use Luxcore after installation, what you can notice is that Luxcore is quite different from cycle. The viewport, the settings, all are really different and they don't react the same way. So what we will cover here is to demystify Luxcore and give you what is under the hood and what makes Luxcore so different, and how you can use the same workflow you have and cycle in your Luxcore engine. So let's start. First of all, when you start a new scene, you have your cube in the center, and if you want to launch a viewport render like you do in cycle, you check this and you have this view. You have a blue background, a blue sky background, and a cube in the side. It is not what you have during cycle. You also have this light. It's normally the same light you have in Blender. But how to make Luxcore react like cycle? First, you have to change the background. So you come into the worlds panel here, and you can see four different kinds of background. You have sky, which is the one you have on the viewport when you set to render preview. And you have HDRI, if you want to add an HDRI. And you have flat color. This is the background you have by default in cycle. So if you set your viewport, your world to flat color, you get a flat white color like this is here. So in cycle you have a gray background, so you have to set it to gray and to have the same looking result. Okay, but one thing you will notice is that you have set the color to gray, but the sky is still white, and you have the light coming from the lamp here, very bright here. Why is that? Okay, I will explain it, but before that, turn the sky to none. This will set no background for you. Okay, none, and we have this shiny light on the cube. We had a plane to have more visibility. GZ1, okay, and I will help you to understand what is going on. Select your camera, moving on. Okay. In Luxcore, the camera is very important, and you will notice this. Look here. Okay, you have your lamp. You check render, and you have a bright color. Okay, come under lamp settings. And if you decide to change the color of the lamp, you just have to change this color. Okay, the color is changed. But you will notice that you have two different settings for the power and the emission of the light here. So you have the power and you have the efficacy. So what does it mean? Power is the real power of your light source. It's up to you. And efficacy is a kind of multiplier for your power number here. Why Luxcore use this? It is because of the kind of number you can find on real light set, reference. And when you look at your box, you can see here, like the light put is set in lumens, like in Luxcore. Efficacity, when you look here on your luminous efficacity in lumens per watt. Okay, it is this value that you can use here, but this will be a different I will give another explanation for this setting. So usually if you want to use Luxcore like you do with cycle, you just have to put one here, it's no matter, and you have power here. You have also the radius of your light, and if you want the shadow to be a bit soft, you increase 0.1. You have softness here. You put one meter. You see the light becomes softer and softer. But there is a point when you move the cube, you can see when you move the thing, when you turn around it, you can see that the brightness of the overall 3D scene change. The brightness is really changing. So why this? If you also change the value here, like this, you can see that nothing happening. It is the same bright light. Light is not changing. So 1000, and this is the same. You put one, and it's the same. So what is happening? Luxcore lighting is very, very linked to the tone mapper. So there is a tone mapper inside Luxcore, and by default, this tone mapper is set to automatic exposure. So how to change this to make it react like cycle? Go to select your camera here, select the camera, and then you have Luxcore image pipeline and tone mapper activated. You have to uncheck this box, auto brightness, and you see the viewport become black. So change this value by one, and this is for consistency, as we have one for efficacy here. It is the value I usually use. This is for consistency. You can use the number you want, but for me, I use one, and also efficacy one to be really, really consistent in my settings. So one, and you have one here. If you want now to have change to have more light, set to 100, and you see the light is changing. If you want to have more light, 500, light is changing because we have changed the tone mapper. Select your camera, come to the tone mapper, and you see that one, not auto brightness. If you check this box, you have the same problem. And if you uncheck it, your rendering start to look more like cycle one. So check 100, you have less light, 50, less light, 500, more light. Okay, you have to reduce here. And when you have check, when you have your tone mapper set to linear, now you have to understand a bit about the light, the other light source. So suppose that you want to add a new light source, maybe a sun. So you decide to delete your your lamp or move it another layer or delete it completely. Okay, come back and add a sun. You just have shift R and add a sun, move your sun, and then launch under, and you see that the light emitted by the sun in Luxcore is very, very high. This is a different point between Cycle and Luxcore. Cycle have a very low powerful sun, so Luxcore is quite different. The power of the sun in Luxcore is said to be by default a real world power. So it is very high. If you want the Luxcore sun to behave a bit like Cycle one, you have to reduce the gain of the sun here by 10,000. This is what I do, 1 per 10,000. So I tip it like this, so Blender can do the math for me. Okay, so you have 0.0001. okay, now you have a less blinding sun. You can reduce it even more by putting 10 here, and you have something like this. So this value is equal to 1 per 100,000. Okay, 1 per 100,000. It is the same value. So if you want to double the value, you just have to put 2 instead of 1, and you have it. If you want to have soft shadow from the sun, you just have to change relative size of the sun and put something like 12, and you see that softness is starting, and 24, and you have more softness. If you want to color the sun, you just have to do like this. It is quite simple. Okay, and now suppose that you don't want to have just this black background, and you want to have a sky. So you come back to word panel and you add sky. Okay, it start to be blinding again. So it is the same things for the sun. The sun and the sky in Luxcore are very, very brighter light source. So if you want them to be less bright, you have to divide the number, the gain, by 100,000. 100,000. Okay. And you have this. Change the gain to be white, to have all the blue color coming. Okay, if you change this color, you see that your sky is affected. So let it white, and you can see that you have your sun somewhere here. This is your sun disk. Suppose that you want the sun and the sky to be to be linked and to be at the same way. What you have to do is just to use this and select your sun like this, and you select it, and you have now your sun connected to your sky. If you do this, you can see that the color is automatically changed. Okay, you can also have the same thing to attach, to link your sun to your sky. When you go in sun panel, you have this attached to sky, and when you click on it, you can have the same behavior. Okay, this is mostly all about it. Okay, now that you understand the why and the sun and the sky are so bright in Luxcore, you can now decide to try HDRI. So delete your sun, come to sky, and just come to HDRI. So you have this panel, and if you want another HDRI, you are just to click on open, go to your HDRI folder, select one of them, open, and then render. It is simply black. Why? Because here the gain is too low, so put one and it is whole, as you can see. And what is happening here is that the gain is the same for all the lights. So if I change it here, it is the same value for, okay, I have one for HDRI. And if I want to soft my HDRI shadow, how I can do this? I can simply come in the setting again and set gamma either, no, lower, okay. And you see that you have flat HDRI. If you increase 0.91, 0.7, you can see that your shadow is starting to be less visible. So 0.85, you have a bit less shadow. You can increase the light coming from your HDRI, and you can see it's working. So nothing magic, this is just simple. If you want to turn your background, you just have to move this z-axis rotation, and it is done. Simple. Okay, now maybe you want to understand a bit more about the about the render settings. By default, the viewport is using your CPU to render. So if you come here in the render panel, you have here your settings for your viewport. So let me move it like this. Okay, you have CPU and OpenCL. Okay, CPU and OpenCL. If you want your GPU to render the viewport, you just have to select OpenCL and wait a bit. Luxcore will use your GPU to render the viewport. So it is a bit faster, but less responsive, as you use the same GPU for render and for view. So you have less responsiveness. So now if you here you have the setting to for the amount of time that the viewport is rendered. So if you reduce it by 5 seconds, you have less render time. If you increase it by 1 minute 60 seconds, you move and you see that it is counting here 3 seconds, 4 seconds until it's reached the number of 60 seconds. Okay. You can also use your normal workflow about color management in Blender. So you can use Filmic like you do every time, Filmic, and it's change default Filmic. Okay, you can use gamma, you can use your curves like you do every time. So this is working quite the same. You can reset the value and check. Let's give Filmic 1.0. Okay, come back, and this is all. It's nothing complicated. If you come again in the render settings, you have your CPU for the final render, CPU and path tracing. Here you have OpenCL if you want to use your GPU. Okay, so you select OpenCL for the final render to use your GPU. This also helps you if you want to use your GPU plus your CPU. In Luxcore, you have the possibility to use all your hardware processor. I have one Titi, one Hawaii AMD GPU, and one CPU. So if I uncheck this box, the CPU will not be used. Luxcore use C++ for CPU rendering and OpenCL for GPU rendering. So you can use both of them and see the result. Compiling time, F12. And you have both your GPU and your CPU rendering at the same time. So look at it. Okay, CPU is 100%. Okay, and if you come to GPU Z, you can see that all my CPU are also rendered. GPU loads 100, and this one also is 199. Okay, you can stop the rendering and came back to another things. Also, when you want to avoid fireflies in Luxcore, you also have to this option, clamp output. So you check it, and you can use number to a good number to clamp and avoid fireflies. Luxcore help you after your first render to set a suggestion, a good value. Okay, and you have it. If you test and you see that the you have some fireflies, you can reduce this value. If you have not fireflies, but your rendering is starting to be black and more dark, you just have to increase the value. So this is all, and you also have these settings. Note that for Luxcore, they are completely independent. So you have four for the diffuse, four for the glossy, and six for the specular, and the total path depth is 6. Okay, let me explain you a bit about this. Suppose that you want let the render start. Okay, I think the viewport is already set to OpenCL, so let's go back to CPU to have more responsivity, and come back. And okay, if I set the total path of diffuse to 1, the rendering is starting to be dark in diffuse shadings. 0, it is also 1. If I had another object, a sphere or Susan, monkey. Okay, add our monkey here. Okay, and we want to add a glossy shader, metal. Okay, and another. You can see. Okay, normal. And if I check here to 1, you can see start to be dark. If I set it to be 5, start to be clear, but the diffuse is not changing, it's completely independent. If I set the diffuse to 5, I get okay, diffuse is darkening while my glossy is always good. Let me add a specular object. Sphere, subsurf, smooth, and then material, add basic glass, and then render. Okay, normal glass. And if you come to change specularity, specular path to 1, dark, specular 2, less dark, 4, less dark, but set it to 12, for example, no change. Why? It is because there is a roadblock. This value act like a limit, it stop all number trying to go beyond this value. So if I set it to 12, I will start to get a bit more light, all the path from the specular. If I set it to 1, you will cut all the path coming from diffuse 1, glossy will set to 1 also, and specular will be set to 1. If I set it to 2, every path will be set to 2, but this one will stay 1, okay, because it's not going beyond the idle value here. So if you set it to 4, you will see that it is the same two path result. If you set it to 4 here, you have more light coming from here, but if you set it to 2, you have less light. Okay, simple. For the other settings, I think we have to make another tutorial, but this is for explanation about the difference between cycle and Luxcore. So let me make a summary. When you start a new project with Luxcore, you have to bear in mind that the default sky in Luxcore is too powerful. You also have to change. The first thing to do for me when you start a new project with Luxcore and you want to keep your same workflow you have in cycle is to select your camera, go to tone mapper, and be sure that auto brightness is unchecked. Set your gain value, I use 1, and add your light. Suppose you want to use a simple lamp render, and you see that I have the background again. So HRI, no HRI, but white background. So set it to none and you have your light again. You come here. If you are not going to use scientific simulation, please get this to one. Set your shadow softness, change your power like you want, and it is all. It's not complicated, so this is all. Okay, you just have to remember, select your camera, go to tone mapper, change to linear to have the same behavior you have in cycle. But another one thing, if you add a new camera, you will see something again. Okay, if you add a new camera 001, you will see that there is something. Every new camera added in Luxcore will be set to auto exposure. So you have to do the same, uncheck this box, use your favorite value, and it's okay. Okay, this settings is for people who want to use real world camera. This one is Reinhardt. You can have more information on Wikipedia to see how it works, but it's nothing complicated. You also have some post-projection effect here, color aberration. You can set the strength, okay, like this. You also have vignettings, increase, decrease. It works on the viewport and also on the final render. So, okay, it is all about. With this workflow, you can create and this kind of image you see on the beginning of the tutorial. It is the same workflow. For the lighting, I simply use a lamp and on my word panel I use a flat color, nothing more. As you can see, I use this method to create this scene. Okay, just a flat color, gain set to 2, because flat color are not so powerful, they are different from sky, so I can set my gain 2, I can use 2 here. And I decide to not use a sun for this project, I use a lamp, and I want this lamp to have a really really powerful light. So I decide to let this number to 17. I can use one here, I have less light, but I will have to increase this value as it acts like a multiplier. So something like 100,000, and it gave me almost the same result. So if I want to use a friendly value, just put 2,000 and I increase this value here. You can also use your number you want. I can use 30 and use your less arrow value, something like 1000, and to the same. So it depends on you. I can also change this to use a sun, okay, normal sun. You can see that I have the light coming, I have sharp shadow. If I want to add soft shadow, I use higher value. Shadow start to be soft, but the sun is too bright. If I want a less bright sun, I can just come here, use and you can see it is simple, nothing complicated. If I want to double the light like this, I can just use it like this and it is the same. Depend on you. Okay, but I prefer to use my point light with gain set to 1 because lamp are a less powerful light source, and here set to 2000 and here set to 17. Okay, and this is all about it. You can see also my camera is also set to auto exposure is disabled, and I use one here. It's not complicated. Okay, thank you for watching this tutorial, and if you have questions, don't forget to go on Luxcore website. Okay, go to the forum, create, and you can ask any question you want on the user support, and we will answer you. If you want to see how Luxcore is performing, you can go on Luxcore website and go on the gallery, and you will see what you can get. Okay, everything is okay. So thank you for watching and see you for the next tutorial. I think.